This film was made as part of the Common Cause Research Project, which aims to understand how universities and Black and minority ethnic communities build collaborations. Each of these films tells a different story of how these collaborations might work. They range from long-term partnerships to short-term projects and events. The films are designed to prompt discussion and reflection. We encourage you to ask, what questions might be learned for the future from these stories?
If I felt that my grandfather had anything to do with this, I would have had a different sense of pride that would have been instilled in me that actually this is part of my history.
Remembering and acknowledging the contribution of Black poppies in the First World War. A digital storytelling project working with young people from a Congolese background. We provide advice, and beside that we do the promotion of African culture and heritage. We had an idea of organizing a project which gonna acknowledge the contribution made by a Congolese soldier in the First World War. And then I met a guy, a photographer, we talked about it. And then Dan knew Dima, he told Dima about my idea of the project. And Dima was looking, or the Birmingham City University was looking for a partner in the community sector.
He came as a volunteer, that's quite important to remember, volunteer, to join the British West Indies Regiment.
Birmingham City University is one of the First World War engagement center.
Some of the troops got so hungry that they actually were willing to take a rotting horse or parts of a rotting horse and actually use it as their food.
The project is supposed to start when the funding is in. But we started the project without funding because the time that was given for the project to end was coming up. It was a 6-month project. Photographic company came to provide digital training to the young people. I went to Congo to try to source for stories from the actual witness of the servicemen who fought in Congo. This person gave me those two pictures. Leaving Kisangani, it's a province in the Congo, going to Mombasa. You know, in the Congo, we have street names like Tabora, Nyanza, Kabalo. It was during the project that we found out that these names came from Tanzania. When the Congolese soldiers fought in Tanzania, every battle that they won, they brought the name back. This young lady, she's alive. She's 60-something now. That's the daughter of this man who's who fought in the First World War I. He was not a serviceman, but he was a porter. They showed me the picture, then I photographed them. I went there, I picked up the stories, came back. We went to record some stories from living relatives of other Black servicemen. We found two in London. We traveled to Kidderminster, outside Birmingham, that's in West Midlands. We recorded some stories there. What was a joy? Learning new skills and new things. The way the project was set up was not convenient for the young people. Most of my young people live in Newtown. Coming here, this is a kind of an isolated area, but there was not allowance for the travel expenses for the young people. For example, going to London to people's houses, we had to use a car because the train was expensive for us. There were three young people plus myself. What was the struggle? Funding. For me, collaboration first means you working in partnership on an equal stance. I think the first invoice took 2 months. We are here, they are here. I had mixed feeling. What I mean by mixed feeling is at the same time, you want to collaborate with a university, then at the same time you say, oh, why did I get myself into this? Yeah, because it was in the middle of the project. You can't go back. You can't stop. When we started the first meeting, Dima said it's a research project. At the end, the academic part gonna produce a report, 15,000 words. The project has ended 1 year ago. Since today, I've not seen that report.
What advice would you give to someone like you who was starting out a project with a university?
It's a kind of, before you get into the collaboration or partnership, you have to pre-meeting first to discuss about how it's gonna work, who's gonna do what, and who's gonna be what. And don't just jump in it. What was missed? Trust.
You think of three different things that would make it better.
The budget has to be real. That's meaning we have to do the budgeting, the costing, then if you have money, we do the project. If you don't have money, we don't do the project. Change your system of financing the project. You finance the project, we provide you with the receipt. Don't wait for the invoice. Sit on the table, around the table as equal partner. Yeah, we discuss things, we execute things together.
If you are interested in finding out more about the project, please go to the Common Cause website.